When spring finally is here and it comes to turkey hunting, one of my favorite ways to go after turkeys is sitting in ground blinds. Now, I've decided that ground blinds can be one of the most fun and effective ways to hunt, but there's a lot of tips and tactics that go along with it. So this entire episode, it's gonna be dedicated to ground blind gobblers. We're gonna go over what makes it fun, how to be more successful, and you get to see a lot of great turkey footage.
That Tom came right in and he didn't wait 1 minute. He jumped on that decoy. That's exactly how decoys are supposed to work. These Dave Smith decoys, the birds can't resist them. I don't know how many times poor little Bubbles has been mounted, and now I think she's got blood on her and feathers all around her. So all in a good day's work. I'm hoping to get out of this blind and go check out this huge bird because he looked like he had a giant beard on it. In fact, I think it was hitting Bubbles right in the face. Well, this is exactly what I like to see. This gobbler didn't go far at all. I'm only 25 yards from the blind. But this is what I... Check that out. Now that is a nice beard. Just a beautiful, beautiful gobbler. We're in Illinois and these are some of the biggest easterns around. I mean, with a fan like that, coming in, putting on a show, turkey hunting is so amazing. It's a way that you can get out in the spring, have great hunting set up, kind of early mornings, but I really enjoy it. Beautiful bird, and well, we definitely have a fighter. It's got a little bit of busted up spurs here. Very, very cool. Now that is what morning should be like. Hearing gobblers all day, coming in, getting on your decoys, and these birds are being fooled completely. Even once they get on, they have no idea that she's still plastic and keep going, giving you the perfect broadside shot if you set up your decoys right. So this bird is gonna be another good eater and I can't wait to get him home.
Sportsman's Alliance, our heritage, our fight, protecting hunting from coast to coast.
Did you know the Sportsman's Alliance submitted comments in support of U.S. Fish and Wildlife's proposed delisting of Greater Yellowstone Ecosystem grizzly bears and are preparing to defend the action in court? Just another fun fact showing you how sportsmen and women are helping make a difference. Out hunting ground blinds, it is a lot of fun. You get away with a little bit more movement, but you also get to sit back and watch the show with your decoys. And that's something that over the years I have really enjoyed. I love to sit back and watch those toms go crazy in the decoys, and it does make it exciting. In fact, I think I have no idea how many gobblers get away because I become so mesmerized in watching them getting footage and just having a wonderful time. And that's what it's all about. So on this next hunt, well, I was headed to Kansas and we got a great start right off the bat. After several close calls and numerous encounters with Jake's, we still didn't have a gobbler down. But as I looked out into the field, I saw a big tom running right for us. He started speeding up, and the next thing I saw was a big coyote chasing him. This wasn't 75 yards from where the bobcat attack had taken place, but luckily, this gobbler escaped and the coyote switched his attention to our decoy instead. I figured he was going to try to get downwind like coyotes always do, but I was hoping maybe I could get a shot before that. He could tell something was not quite right, and so he decided to circle downwind, and he got our scent before I was able to take a shot and just took off. I love seeing coyotes, and I love shooting them even more. But that didn't happen, and now he had cleared the entire area of turkeys. As he ran off, we continued to call, and it wasn't long, and we had a gobble. A few turkeys started trickling back out at the far end of the field, and I looked over, and two big toms came flying out of the tall grass right on our side. We just had two giant gobblers come flying out of the side, ran right into our decoys, and the dominant bird just started slapping the Jake. I'm telling you what, there's buck fever, that is turkey fever. I'm shaking so bad. These gobblers really got me excited. And the coolest part is, I saw the bird go right down. It was just a little bit to the right, but he's down in the tall grass. I did not see this. This guy has a double beard. That is a complete added bonus. When those two toms just came sprinting around the edge, I literally was shaking worse than on a big buck. These turkeys really get me excited. And just a nice, beautiful fan. Got nice spurs on this bird. And the absolute bonus is this double beard. I just had no idea. Just an awesome deal.
This segment was brought to you by Boss Buck. For the most user-friendly and dependable feeder on the market, choose Boss Buck feeders. Now you're getting serious. Winchester Deadly Passion is presented by Cuttyback Digital, more deer, fewer blanks. Hard-hitting Easton Arrows. Golden Triangle Whitetail. Winchester, the American legend. National Deer Alliance, HHA Sports, Scent Killer Gold with Hunt Dry Technology, apply it, dry it, and go hunt. Rage Broadheads, leading the evolution in lethal technology. Convergent Hunting Solutions, where experience, innovation, and passion meet. Sportsman's Alliance, protecting hunting from coast to coast. Engel Coolers, the original high-performance cooler company, and Moose Utility Division, your leader in ATV, UTV accessories.
This entire episode is dedicated to ground blind gobblers. We're going after turkeys in ground blinds, but there's a lot of different tips and tactics that you can learn and use to your advantage. Now, one thing, when you put a ground blind out, you don't have to worry about it like you would deer. Most turkeys, they don't seem to mind one bit, so put that ground blind exactly where you want to be. Episode.
We just had some deer finally come through our setup. It has been probably the toughest turkey hunting weather I've ever seen. I mean, it has been raining literally nonstop for 2 days. Today's the first day it's starting to get a little bit nicer, and I've been sitting here most of the morning, so I'm hoping these deer are up and moving. That might get all the rest of the animals up and moving. The turkeys can't stay in a tree all day, so hopefully with a little luck, some of these turkeys will come through before one. That turkey just came in out of the blue. I had a hen right here, I was busy filming her, and he just came from the side. The next thing I know, I hear him swatting the decoy. He was beating up my Jake. What a beautiful gobbler. What an absolutely awesome bird. Check out the number of these beards. Look at this. I think this, he does. He has three separate beards. Really a nice bird. And very, very nice spurs as well. We're down here in Illinois, and these Easterns, they are some huge birds. I mean, the tail fan on this, it's about as wide as my shoulders. Just an awesome experience. And turkey hunting has been tough this week. I've been down here in the rain. It's pretty much been raining nonstop for 2 days. Today's finally the third day. We got a little bit of a break, and this turkey came rolling right in. And these decoys were looking pretty good, and that's exactly what he eyed in on. I'm down here at Golden Triangle. I've had some pretty good luck in this field. I've taken two beautiful bucks in this field, and now an absolutely awesome turkey. So very, very exciting, and this is one big turkey.
Tip of the Week is brought to you by HHA Sports, the world's number one selling single pin adjustable bow sight.
When it comes to spring turkey hunting, well, it's one of my favorite times of the year. But the one really cool thing for this season that's totally different, well, I'm using the Longbeard XR. Now, this is a new turkey load by Winchester, and it is really something special. Now, usually 40 yards has been the max, but with the Longbeard XR, well, you're able to get twice the amount of pellets at 60 yards than any other standard lead load. So the first thing I ask is, what changed? Well, it's the shot lock technology. With this technology, when you squeeze the trigger, that momentum accelerating all the way out to 1200 feet per second, well, it's going to fracture all that stuff around the pellets, and when it comes out, it's gonna hold a tighter group because of that. With that tighter group, well, what that means for you is better long range capability. You're gonna be able to take those 60 yard shots. Now, of course, you wanna get on the range and you wanna put in your time. But now you're gonna have an ammo that can hold up to anything you may need. We all like to bring birds right in our lap, but we all know that doesn't always happen. And when it doesn't, well, now you've got the Longbeard XR to help you out. And when it comes to spring turkey hunting, well, it is a lot of fun, but I'm definitely gonna try to put every advantage in my favor.
This segment was brought to you by Convergent Hunting Solutions. Try their electronic game calls today, featuring Bluetooth technology to work right with your smartphone. Winchester Deadly Passion is presented by Winchester, the American legend. Matthews Archery, catch us if you can. Field and Stream, where traditions begin. ScoutLookWeather.com. Download the free ScoutLook hunting app for your smartphone. Rangemaster Trailers. Luxury gone rugged. Master Hand Milling. Revolutionizing the range. Reinhardt. The best archery targets in the world. Garmin. Enhance your outdoor adventures. Winchester Repeating Arms. Sure Shot Jewelry. Check out the Melissa Bachman collection today. And Boss Buck, for the most user-friendly and dependable feeder on the market. Now you're getting serious. Closed captioning is brought to you by Cuddyback Digital. Upgrade to Cuddyback and your images will never look better.
Up this episode on ground blind gobblers, one of the things you want to remember is that you really do have time. When these turkeys come in, a lot of time they are so fixated on the decoys that you do not have to worry about your movement and you have a little bit of time. But patience is key. There's not always movement, there's not always tons of turkeys in there, and there are times when it gets downright boring. But you need to wait it out because in the end, it definitely is worth it. On this next segment, well, I was headed to South Dakota on the Rosebud Reservation with my good friend, Ben Bearshield. We were gonna be hunting ground blinds and I knew we were right in the turkeys. So we put all our decoys out and I littered the area with cameras. I wanted to make sure to capture this from every angle possible. But we were there pretty early because we didn't want to have the chance of spooking any turkeys that could potentially come in. We got there apparently a little too early because by the time we finally got a gobble and had a gobbler coming in, all my cameras were dead. But that's pretty typical. The camera in the blind was still good, so as we called, this gobbler was going crazy, back and forth, and my heart was pounding.
Nothing like having them in close.
That worked just like we thought it would.
I think he would have stayed all day if
he would have. No. He'd be here for half an hour if we let him.
I waited for quite some time and then I'm like, well, he wouldn't clear that decoy. The last thing I wanted to do was put a big hole in the side of my decoy.
I know.
I actually was starting to think that he was going to be a double beard. Well, he just got one.
It was kind of separated there as he came in. I thought it was two.
Boy, was I shaking. You know what? It's awesome calling him in from that far, but boy, do you get shook up on it. Just a nice fan. Wow, that was awesome.
This segment was brought to you by Rangemaster Trailers, the ideal combination of rugged durability and luxurious comfort. Built on a lightweight all-aluminum frame, the Rangemaster can be customized for all your hunting adventures. Rangemaster Trailers, luxury's gone rugged. Follow Melissa on Twitter at Melissa Bachman, on Facebook at facebook.com/Winchester Deadly Passion, and Instagram at Melissa_Bachman for behind-the-scenes footage, photos, giveaways, and much more.